Well, in my last lecture, we discussed about the effect of source impedance on the performance of single phase converters. In this lecture, I shall be discussing the effect of source impedance on the three phase converters. Now, just to recall the single phase full converter, if there is no inductance at the converter side, we say that T1 and T2, when they were conducting, the circuit was like this. And when T3 and T4 are triggered, immediately the current gets transferred from T1, T2 to T3 and T4. The transfer of current is immediate if there is no source inductance. But we discussed that when the source inductance enters any circuit, the transfer of current from T1, T2 to T3, T4 doesn't happen immediately. Rather, there is a delay which is introduced because of the presence of this inductance. Now, this inductance causes this delay, because of which the current of the outgoing thyristor, it reduces slowly, and current through the incoming thyristor, it rises slowly, and this time is called the overlap period. We discussed that the effect of source impedance is to lower the mean output voltage. Now you can see during this overlap period, the output voltage is reduced to zero. So that means if you find out the average voltage for this waveform, it will be reduced. Second effect is to distort the output voltage and current waveforms. You can see, because here the voltage has become zero, so voltage is distorted. Otherwise, it would have been positive during this time. So this voltage is distorted, and similar way the current is also distorted. The third effect is to modify the performance parameters of the converter. So if the output voltage is changed, the parameters will be affected accordingly. So let us see. Okay, this was the factor by which the voltage was reduced. So the output voltage, which is 2Vm by pi cos alpha in case of full converters, this gets reduced by omega Ls by pi into I naught. So this is the factor by which the voltage gets reduced, and this may be considered as the effect of the inductance. Now let us see what is its effect on the three phase converters. In three phase converters, please recall that for any three phase full converter at a time, there are two devices which are conducting. At a time, two devices conduct. Every device will conduct for 120 degree. At a time, one device from positive group and one device from negative group will conduct. So at a particular instant, there will be one thyristor from 1, 3 and 5 which will be conducting, and there will be another thyristor from 4, 6 and 2 that will be conducting. Each thyristor will conduct for 120 degree while the combination will conduct for 60 degree. Just try to recall this switching sequence. So in this switching sequence, when T5 goes out, T1 comes in. When T1 goes out, T3 comes in. When T3 goes out, T5 comes in. This is what happens in the positive group. And from the lower group, when T6 goes out, T2 comes in. When T2 goes out, T4 comes in. So in all our earlier studies, we discussed, we considered the source inductance as zero. And that is why we considered that whenever T1 is fired, T5 immediately goes out. But because of the presence of source inductance, it will not happen. The presence of source inductance, it delays the current. Because of this delay in current, the changeover from 5 to 1, it takes some time, and that time is called as the commutation interval or the overlap period. Now let us see what happens in a three phase rectifier. Let us consider this case. Let us say T5 is going out and T1 is coming in. So during this time, this is the time when these two thyristors 5 and 1 will be conducting. So these two will conduct simultaneously for this particular period. These two will conduct simultaneously for this period. Similarly, after 60 degree, what will happen? These two will conduct simultaneously. Similarly here, so in one cycle of 360 degree, there will be six instances at which the overlapping will happen. Three instances will be from the positive side, three will be from the negative side. And during each overlap time, one thyristor will be outgoing, another thyristor will be incoming. So at that time, what will be the average voltage? What will be the output voltage? The output voltage will correspond to the average of outgoing and the incoming one. Now, what is it? Let us try to understand with the example of 5 and 1. 5 is connected to phase C. P5 is connected to phase C, while 1 is connected to phase A. Now, 5 is with phase C, 1 is with phase A. Now, this is the time, overlap time, during which phase A and C both are conducting from the positive side. So, both are conducting means VC which is rising and VA which is decaying, both are on. So, the output will be an average of VC and VA. So, during this time, we will say that the output average voltage is VA plus VC upon 2. Likewise, here in this case, T6 and T2 are conducting. T6 is connected to B. T2 is connected to C. So, during this time, phase B and C are conducting. So, phase B is this and phase C is this. So, at this time, the average, only for this particular time, the output voltage will be an average of these two phases. So, it will be a straight line here. So, for every commutation interval, you will find a straight line. And this straight line indicates that there is a small triangle which is formed. This triangle is, this is J, J, L, K. This is the triangle which is chopped because of the presence of source inductance. And this is the loss of voltage. Otherwise, we would have got this voltage at the output. Now here, we have considered the firing angle as zero. Although for the ease of understanding, we have considered the alpha as zero. Otherwise, for any value of alpha, the effect is going to be same. So this is the voltage which is chopped. Let us see what output voltage we will get. So to find out the output voltage V naught, let us first see what is the voltage which is chopped here. So what is the fall in voltage? Now this chopped voltage is happening from 0 degree. Why we are considering it zero? Because this is the instant where T1 is fired, and this instant is considered as the zero instant of the firing. So we will say that the voltage during this time, because the pulse is considered from this point to this point. This is the 60 degree point. The pulse is considered for every 60 because it's a 6 pulse converter. So for every 60 degree, we'll be getting a pulse. So that means if you wish to find out the periodic time will be taken as 60 degree. Now here, the voltage is chopped from 0 to mu because this angle is mu. So what we can do is, if we differentiate the inductance voltage with respect to omega t, and the differentiation if we integrate the inductance voltage with respect to omega t, and the integration is taken from 0 to mu, then we will get this portion which is chopped. So let us see how we do it. If we integrate the inductance voltage from 0 to mu, This integration is done with respect to omega t. Now omega t is should be for the periodic time, the omega t should be taken as 60 degree. So it is taken as pi by 3. So 1 upon pi by 3 will give you 3 by pi. Now if we solve this, if we put the value of VL as LS di by dt and we integrate it from 0 to pi, 0 to mu, we get the fall in voltage as 3 omega LS by pi into I. Please mind it, this is not the output voltage, this is the fall in output voltage. This is the voltage which is chopped here. So for every 60 degree, this is the voltage which is chopped. Now you can also find it if you make the integration with respect to t. If you are making the integration with respect to t, so that means from 0 to t, omega t. Omega t means from 0 to t, the current is rising from 0 to I naught, and the omega t equals to pi by 3. Omega t equals to pi by 3 means omega t equals to pi by 3 means t equals to pi by 3 omega. So here it is the one which is taken. So this similar equation can be taken if it is integrated with respect to t or omega t, the result, end result will be the same. So this is the voltage that is chopped. Now if we reduce this voltage from the output of the converter, which is this voltage? This is voltage when there is no overlap happening. That means when there was no load inductance, at that time the voltage was 3 VML by pi cos alpha. So this is the output of a three phase converter. If we subtract this drop 3 omega LS by pi into I naught, if we subtract this drop from the output of a 6 pulse converter, we get the effect as the output voltage as V naught X. So this is the output voltage that we get for a three phase converter. Now in general also we can use the similar kind of calculations for any pulse. So for a P pulse converter, the calculations can be found out by this equation, and the mean output voltage for a P phase converter can be given by this. So for a two pulse converter, if you insert the value of P here and the maximum voltage, you get the output voltage as 2 VM by pi cos alpha minus omega LS I naught by pi. This is similar to that we derived in single phase converters with inductance LS. And for a 6 pulse, the equation is 3 VML by pi cos alpha minus this. This is the same equation, that is equation number 1 that we derived here. For a 3 pulse converter, this can be written as this. So this equation is very similar to the single phase converter. The only difference is in the single phase converter, this is 2 VM by pi cos alpha, and this 3 is not there, it is omega LS by pi into I naught, because that in that case the phase is 1, but here the phases are 3. So V output is 3 VML by pi cos alpha, and this is the factor by which the output voltage is reduced. So similar equation can be shown by the DC equivalent circuit. This is a similar kind of circuit that we did draw for a single phase converter. Here the maximum voltage is taken as 3 VML by pi cos alpha. This is the case when there is no source inductance. So with the presence of source inductance, this is the resistance which is caused, and the output voltage becomes 3 VML by cos alpha minus 3 omega LS by pi into I naught. So this is the similar kind of effect that we have seen for a single phase converter. So to conclude, let me tell you, there are three major effects of the presence of source inductance. The very first effect is the output voltage is reduced. The output voltage is reduced by this factor. What is the second effect? Second effect is it changes the waveform. It changes the waveform. Here it is seen. The waveform is changed. And third is, because it has changed the waveform, it will have direct impact on the performance of the converters. So these are the three effects which are taken into account when the source possesses the inductance in it. Well, I think this is enough for today. I have taken the similar reference, Power Electronics by P.S. Bhimra. In my next lecture, I shall discuss dual converters. Thank you.